Good afternoon to all of you. Myself Vikas Yadav from Buddha Institute of Pharmacy. Today we will discuss about sedatives and hypnotic agents. So when we discuss about sedatives and hypnotics, then sedatives and hypnotics are the agents which depress central nervous system. Hypnotics are the agents that induce sleeping. So these are utilized in the treatment of insomnia, sleeping disorder, insomnia. But sedatives are the agents that does not induce sleep, rather than these are the agents which decrease the excitation of nervous system. During the time of anxiety, our nervous system excessive excitement occurs. So the sedatives are the agents which decrease excessive excitement but does not cause or does not induce sleep. In the category of sedatives and hypnotics, the drugs are common. So sedative nature and hypnotic nature are totally depend on dose, quantity. So first we will discuss about classification of sedatives and hypnotics. When we classify sedatives and hypnotics, then sedatives and hypnotics are classified in three categories. First one is barbiturates, second one is benzodiazepines, and third one is newer drugs, are called as non-benzodiazepines new drugs. In barbiturates, there are several drugs are present. First, we will discuss about barbiturates. Basically, all the barbiturates are barbituric acid derivatives. Barbituric acid is the condensation product of malonic acid and urea. Barbituric acid itself don't exhibit the activity of sedatives or hypnotics, but when substitution occurs, then derivatives of barbituric acids cause the sedative and hypnotic nature. In barbiturates, therapeutic index or therapeutic window are so small. It means the difference between therapeutic dose and difference between toxic dose are too small. So when we use barbiturates in any treatment, then extra caution is necessary, because slightly above dose can cause toxicity, or it may fatal to patient, it may cause death. Barbituric acid derivative or barbiturates, the drugs are known as such as phenobarbitone, butabarbitone, pentobarbitone, thiopentone, and methohexitone. In the category of benzodiazepines, the drugs are lorazepam, diazepam, flurazepam, and nitrazepam. In the category of newer drugs or non-benzodiazepine derivatives, that are zolpidem and others. So when we discuss about barbiturates, then first, all barbiturates are barbituric acid derivatives. Barbiturates itself don't exhibit the activity of sedatives or hypnotics, but after substitution by alkyl or aryl group, they exhibit the property of sedatives or hypnotics. Barbiturates are further classified into three categories. One is long-acting barbiturates, second one is short-acting barbiturates, and third one is ultra-short-acting barbiturates. Long-acting barbiturates, for example, such as phenobarbitone, short-acting barbiturates, for example, butabarbitone and pentobarbitone, and ultra-short-acting barbiturates, the example are thiopentone and methohexitones. Then we will discuss about pharmacological action of barbiturates. First action, effect on central nervous system. All the barbiturates cause depression on central nervous system. So they are used as a sedatives or hypnotics, anticonvulsants, along with general anesthetic agents. If we remember about previous lectures, then we will study, when we will study about general anesthetic agent, then in the category of intravenous anesthetic agents, thiopentone are considered. Thiopentone is a barbiturate. When we saw the effect on sleep of barbiturates, then all barbiturates induced sleep, but after awaking they produce hangover. When we study about analgesic effect of barbiturates, then barbiturates itself don't exhibit the analgesic effect until unless the patient goes to unconsciousness. When the patient goes to unconsciousness, then definitely they produce analgesic effect due to CNS depressant. But until unless, they don't exhibit any analgesic action. But they potentiate or induce the action, the analgesic property of salicylic acid and paracetamol. Anesthetic agents, barbiturates such as thiopentone, in a definite dose produce general anesthesia. Again, anticonvulsant effect, all the barbiturates, mainly phenobarbitones, exhibit anticonvulsant effect in a specific dose. Respiration, effect on respiration. Basically, respiration is not affected by sedative or hypnotic agents, but when we taken in very huge quantity for a long time, then it may cause respiratory paralysis and cause death of patient. Effect on gastrointestinal tract. If we study the effect of barbiturates on gastrointestinal tract, then barbiturates don't produce any therapeutic effect on gastrointestinal tract in normal dose, but in heavy dose they decrease the secretion of gastric juice. Then we will discuss about effect of barbiturates on uterus. All the barbiturates in normal dose don't affect on uterine muscles, but in heavy dose it causes uterine contraction depression. Then we will discuss about effect of barbiturates on liver. So all the barbiturates metabolize in liver, so in heavy dose they induced hepatic dysfunction. Now we will discuss about absorption and excretion of barbiturates. Barbiturates are absorbed either via oral route or intravenous route. Barbiturates can also pass via milk. It can penetrate blood placental barrier. So during the time of pregnancy, use of barbiturates is contraindicated because it can pass from blood placental barrier and may induce teratogenic effect or congenital birth defect. It can also secrete from milk. All the barbiturates are chiefly metabolized in liver, but some are metabolized in kidney. They are excreted by the kidney in urine, either in free form, either in glucuronic acid conjugate form. Then now we will discuss about adverse drug reaction. First of all, if we give barbiturates during the time of delivery, then it may cause respiratory depression and fetal death. Intolerance like nausea, vomiting, headache are also present in the barbiturates use. Intolerance like nausea, headache and diarrhea. Then now we will discuss about barbiturates also cause intolerance, addiction, dependence, and they also induced withdrawal symptoms. Therapeutic use. All the barbiturates are used as a anxiolytic agent. It is also used as a hypnotic agent to relieve from insomnia. It is also utilized as a anticonvulsant. It is also utilized as a pre-anesthetic medication. It potentiates the analgesic effect of salicylates. Now we will discuss about benzodiazepines. In the category of benzodiazepines, diazepam, flurazepam, nitrazepam, lorazepam, these are the drugs which are present in the category of benzodiazepines. These are the agents having anticonvulsant effect, sedative effect, hypnotic effect, anxiolytic effect. But the benzodiazepines having very less unconsciousness and respiratory depression. So it is a safe drug rather than barbiturates, because the chance of respiratory depression or respiratory paralysis and the chance of unconsciousness are not present in benzodiazepine use. So the benzodiazepines are preferred as safe drug compared to barbiturates. Now we will discuss about newer drugs or non-benzodiazepines derivatives. So first of all is Jopiclone. First drug is Jopiclone. Jopiclone is a newer drug which is non-benzodiazepine derivatives. Jopiclone is a non-benzodiazepine sedative agent. It is a pyrrolone derivative. It is a cyclopyrrolone derivative. Its shortness, sleep latency, and increased total sleep time. It does not affect REM sleep, and also there is no hangover. Jopiclone. This is known as Jopiclone. It is a cyclopyrrolone derivative known as Jopiclone, non-benzodiazepine and cyclopyrrolone derivative. It does not affect REM sleep and also there is no hangover. Now we'll discuss about Zolpidem. Zolpidem is a imidazopyridine derivative. Jopiclone is a cyclopyrrolone. But Zolpidem is a imidazolpyridine derivative. It decreases sleep latency and increases sleep duration. No tolerance or physical dependence. Low abuse potential. No rebound insomnia. Safety with overdosing is present when we use Zolpidem. So these are the agents which are used in the treatment of sedatives and hypnotics. Up next, we will discuss about drug effective in convulsive disorder such as epilepsy, tremors, seizures. In the treatment of epilepsy, anticonvulsant drugs are utilized such as phenytoin, phenobarbitone, primidone, carbamazepine, ethosuximide, valproic acid and others. These are the drugs which are used in the treatment of epilepsy. So, what is epilepsy? Epilepsy is a collective term applied for a group of convulsive disorder. The common feature of epilepsy are loss of disturbance of consciousness, characteristic body movement, usually but not always, autonomic hyperactivity. The different type of epilepsy are grand mal epilepsy, petit mal epilepsy, psychomotor epilepsy, myoclonic epilepsy. These are the example of types of epilepsy. So, the different type of epilepsy are grand mal epilepsy, petit mal epilepsy, psychomotor epilepsy, myoclonic epilepsy and others. The main features of epilepsy are loss or disturbance of consciousness, characteristic body movement, autonomic hyperactivity. These are the specific features of epilepsy. So these are the drugs which we have discussed about sedatives and hypnotics. In next lecture, we will discuss about various drugs used in convulsion or anti-epileptic agent. Thank you.